Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. There really is no explanation for what I'm going to make today other than I just wanted to see if I could make it happen. I'm going to make spray cheese, or one of the brand names that it goes under in the United States is Ezee Cheese. Cheese in a can, you spray it out on a cracker, big hit at parties. And it's still out there. People still buy it. So I know that people want to know how this is made. And I couldn't find any tutorials online about how to make Ezee Cheese or spray cheese. So I looked at the side of a couple of cans for a couple different brands, looked at the ingredient list and where the ingredients were listed on the list. And I've come up with something that I think might work. I've never tested this before. So you are going to see me either make it or fail right here live on YouTube. So based on the ingredient list that I found on the side of the can, I dug deep into our pantry and I found a series of chemicals that, while not exactly the same as what's on the side of the can, they do exactly the same thing. And in food chemistry, there's often more than one way to reach your goal. What it comes down to is what that particular food processor or manufacturer likes to use in their processes and cost. And sometimes they'll choose the cheaper version or the cheaper way to get to the end product, even though taste and texture will be pretty much exactly the same. So in this pot, I'm going to start out with some milk and some cream. The recipes for spray cheese or Ezee Cheese, that liquid part is whey, which is what's left over when they make the actual cheese. Something that they would normally have to throw out, they're now putting back in and getting you to buy it. I'm also going to put in some neutral oil. This is grapeseed oil, and that's grapeseed with a G. You could use canola, definitely could use canola. I just think that grapeseed has, to me, zero flavor and is going to add some texture without adding any flavor. So I'm going to bring this up to temperature. Not quite a boil, but we do want to get it hot enough to melt the cheese. And this is orange cheddar because what comes out of that can is definitely orange. And this is called an aged or old cheddar. It's a cheddar cheese from the supermarket. And I know that a lot of people in Britain look at the orange cheddar and say, what is that? Why is it orange? In North America, probably half of the cheddar cheese that is sold is orange. So as this comes up to temperature and starts to melt, I'm gonna put in some salt, and this is just plain coarse salt. Nothing special about that one. And I'll just give this a bit of a stir. Not melting quite yet. Now, that brings us to this rogues gallery of food chemistry. This first one is sodium citrate, or it's commonly called sodium citrate. It is actually trisodium citrate, if you want to get, you know, perfectly pedantic. It's an emulsifier. It's going to help keep the fats and the non-fats together without separating, so you don't get sort of a clump of cheese with a thing of oily residue around it. Fairly common in a lot of cheese products, fairly common in a lot of food products in general. So I'm going to put some of that in. This is the next one, and I have to read it off the bag because I can never remember. Sodium hexametaphosphate. Again, it's an emulsifier. You don't need to use both of them. You could add a little bit more of this and less of this, or not have this at all. I'm going to put it in because I think it gives a nice smooth finish. When I make nacho cheese, or when I made American processed cheese a little while ago. Check out that video. Next is citric acid. Most of the brands of spray cheese use lactic acid, and I have lactic acid down in the brewery. I use that in brewing all the time. And the citric acid just gonna give it a little bit of tang, and it's gonna make up for the fact that we're using sort of a lower quality cheddar cheese. It'll make it seem older than it really is. So I'm gonna put that in. And the last thing, of course, is MSG. Now, on the side of the can, they list autolyzed yeast extract. But if you know anything about autolyzed yeast extract, it is really just MSG. Or another name for MSG. And we put that in. It is a flavor enhancer. It'll bring a little bit of saltiness because it's salt as well. But it really is just a flavor enhancer to bump up the fact that that cheddar isn't the greatest cheddar. So the cheese is starting to melt. I'm gonna stir this together, get it melted. This is all melted together pretty nicely, but there's still little threads of cheese throughout. So I'm going to turn off the heat And I'm going to use a stick blender just to emulsify it all together and see if I can get a nice, smooth mixture. Okay, looking good. Now that I've got a nice, smooth mixture, I need to get this into an ISI whipper without spilling everywhere. Do you think I can do it? I might put something down. I might put it in a bowl just because I'm pretty sure I'm going to spill everywhere. And after I get this in, I need to charge it. And so I can either use CO2 or nitrous oxide. And I think I'm going to use nitrous oxide. I know that in the commercial version, it's essentially a plunger inside the can that pushes the cheese out. The gas doesn't come in contact with the cheese. Not that that's a problem, but it's more like a tube of caulking, like a caulking gun. It's essentially a caulking gun that pushes out cheese instead of caulking. Okay, so I don't think I'm going to fill it anymore. You don't want to overfill these ISIs. Okay, screw on the lid. And I've decided to use nitrous oxide. So we put a nitrous oxide canister in the handle and charge it. And just kind of give it a little bit of a shake. Normally you would do this if you're doing whipped cream, for instance. Everything would have to be super cold because you want to whip the cream. I'm not necessarily looking to whip the cheese. I'm just looking to force it out of the canister. And I thought if I did it while the cheese was hot or warm, it wouldn't have a chance to completely solidify and it might come out easier. I'm still a little worried about it coming out of the canister. So I'm going to use a second nitrous oxide. I'm going to put it in. I'm going to charge it. Not really shake it, just kind of go back and forth a few times. I don't know what the right answer is. And then I'm going to leave it upside down. I'll find a bowl or something, and I'm going to leave it upside down to let it cool down to at least room temperature before we give it a try. Because right now it's kind of hot. Hey, Jules.
Hey, Glen.
Would you like to spray your own spray cheese? Would you like to spray your own, or do you want me to spray it for you?
I think that might be too much
that
cheese.
That was too much. That was too much cheese.
Did you want to try again so you're in practice?
Okay, so let's see. It just, the lightest touch.
Oh, see, that's better. Still a little bit, I think a lot of cheese for that little chip.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yes. Okay, as I suspected, I like that.
I am not sure I've ever had spray cheese.
Nope.
No. So is this what you do with it?
I don't know. I don't know what you do with spray cheese. I really don't know what you do with spray cheese. I know it exists, but it's not.
Spray cheese is one of those things that I see on TV, but for whatever reason, you know, I've never had it.
Now.
That being said, I'm not sure I'm that fond of it.
Well, as I...
I will taste it again, but I'm not sure. Really, I just want to operate the spray cheese. I feel like this is a right-handed...
Now, I didn't put it in the fridge. I think if I put it in the fridge, the texture would be a little firmer. The texture would definitely be a little firmer.
You do get a... you could, like, do a whole cake decorating event.
And... some pickled jalapenos put in and ground up really fine with the, would give some
anything
awesome flavor.
Anything that would
flavor.
Pass through
the... Yeah. I mean, you'd have to, you'd really
you
have to...
You could just use pickled jalapeno juice.
You could use just the juice. True. As you can tell, I think this is a winner. I've now on my third one. I can just sit on the couch. You can just sit on the couch and just, instead of dipping, just spray a little bit of cheese on each chip.
Not as fun. Not going to be something that I will be requesting.
Okay. So, we've learned you can do this, but should you?
This is the question.
I'm all for it. Apparently Julie's on the fence.
No, not even on the fence. I just know. No.
Spray cheese.
Not just for New Year's Eve.
Although this year it might have to
be. It might be. It might be what we're... So, I think this is worthwhile. If you have an ISI canister, this is a worthwhile experiment to play with and figure it out, and then flavor it. Put in either jalapenos or chili spice or... I don't know, what else goes in cheese? Anything goes in cheese.
I think the only thing that is fun about it is the fact that it's spray.
That you spray it.
And that is fun. I'll give you that.
So, thanks for stopping by. See you again soon. I'm going to have another one because I think that's a lot of fun. I'm going to ruin my supper.
No.
No. There you go. You have to be very careful.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no. Not for me, not at all.